Testing, testing. 1, 2, hello.
I'm a god.
No recall or intervention can work in this place.
kill a god. Shame on you,
sweet Maribor.
I'm a god. I'm a god. I'm a god. God. I'm a god. I'm a god. I'm a god.
So, getting started today. The list quite grew a bit, and I decided, you know, using the Dagothwave song for the intro, and kind of just to, you know, get into the spirit. And so I just thought, you know, we gotta give it props. Head on over to the Bandcamp, get the track, donate them $1 if you can. I donated a couple of bucks, and thank you. Yay. And yeah, another thing that somebody suggested to me, have guests on the show. I'm doing a little bit more, so it's, there we go. Why not have guests on the show? And, I thought on the stream, I thought that was a fun idea. I talked to a few folks I know. I don't want to name drop people, but some folks were, you know, interested in that. And if you're somebody who wants to guest and we can do something, you know, I mean, let's talk about it. And then, yeah, just a bunch of, to-do items, right? I think the most important thing to be done right now here is this, removal of this mod from mod list because of an apparent, because of a conflict with the BCOM. Beautiful Cities of Morrowind. Excellent mod by Random Pal. And so what we need to do is It's removed it from, just remove it from the mod list. The author is no longer active. Although it is a brilliant mod, kind of a performance hack, you know. The ground cover path is a faster for various reasons rendering path. And so, you know, it takes all those triangles and puts them on the faster path, which is good. But yeah, just conflicts until we have like a better way to maybe generate these or patch them, you know, it's gotta go. Remove my mod from mod list. Silth's combat has a better option, if I'm being perfectly honest, you know. I just made this for fun. I wanted to mess around with writing a Lua mod in Lisp and making a quest and all this kind of stuff. Used Evil Eye's awesome CSJS tool, which is like a quest making thing. Issue cleanup, as I said, you know, it's got a lot going on here. So on Discord, there was a chat about scumpatibility issues. This is one of probably many things that, like, you know, I've noticed playing the game. And it's just like, I keep maybe a running list, or maybe I just don't write it down at all. But this is something that I noticed and just never, like, had time, you know, to dig into deeply. So people on Discord did, which was, you know, really, really great. We got some feedback. Thanks, Glazzy, and everybody involved in the discussion. But the mistify compatibility meshes are incompatible with scummy texture and scummy scum. So we should continue using them. And actually, I'm a little tempted to try and, you know, verify the change on my high-end potato. You know, nothing against my framework. I love it. It's really great. But, you know, I'm pushing it to its limits. In any case, though, eventually to that end, I have moved my gain rig over to my desk. In a future stream, I will, you know, stream from that machine, and we can actually have good performance running OpenMW and anything else, really. Morrowind Plus Plus was a guide that somebody else dropped into the Discord channel that I, frankly, had no idea about. But at a quick glance, it looked amazing. So we might just take a look at that and put it on the maybe the TS3 command page, wherever it fits. Somebody else mentioned pointing to Nexus by default for stuff that has a GitHub link, like Tomb of the Snow Prince. Makes sense. Apparently it's packaged differently. Oh, getting a little popping. Okay. We'll just kind of wondered if my gain was too high there. Stuff like Tomb of the Snow Prince, you know, is apparently packaged different on GitHub. There's no sense pointing people to that, making life more difficult. Should I stream, put a stream link on the website? I don't know. Update Starwind mods. There's a couple Starwind mods that I use that are updated. Let's update them and maybe check them out. This is not necessarily, by the way, in order I'm going to do things. I just thought they ended up right there. The bug report still lingering. More bug reports on my mods. Had a question that lingered from before about better readme instructions. Magamo on Discord helpfully pointed to this, which sounds amazing. Morrowind Acoustic Overhaul Spell Sounds. Acoustic Overhaul being a mod that I don't think is usable with OpenMW, but this little extraction of it is apparently. Beautiful Cities of Morrowind Pylons patch. Not the default in anymore, which is like the Ghost Fence Pylons have like big old swords, like in the concept art, and possibly other things. There's a separate patch, and there was some discussion about what to use, so maybe we'll look at that. Somebody reported to me about a bug with leveling down. I don't usually, you know, I use a custom character usually, and I end up, like, just because of how things crunch, I like level 2 to start. So this is something that I just frankly never saw, so whoops on me. Steam Deck, OpenMW validator points to my source HUD. I should go to GitLab. CI for that, bug report for Delta plugin. There's apparently a few things that various folks have hit, but I myself have hit them, and run mlocks potentially. Get the app image building was something that I did after the last stream, just because I was kind of in the zone and I did that. CI for the app image, meaning that we'll have like a continuous build. Every time OpenMW change happens, we could have a new 0.49 dev build app image. And this is useful to run on the Steam Deck because it's just a single file you can plop into place, you know. I'm not sure if they have a file pack for that yet. Somebody mentioned some feedback about CFG generator and list usage. Maybe we can take a look at that. And yeah, some ideas about making the tools that I use on the server available. And then, yeah, last time I definitely forgot to deploy the site before we ended the stream. So, you know, grant granted, there may not be changes that are going live, maybe just some experimental stuff, but if there are live changes to go, they shall go. And then last thing that I want to do eventually, not going to do today, whoops, is I want to go just over everything once more. I kind of did it on the first two streams, but they weren't saved because I was not aware of that button to click. But yeah, just the website origins, architecture, motivation. Maybe we can even draw a .d2 diagram of the sort of the architecture or whatever. Whoop. I like to punch my mic. And then, yeah, maybe just go over my workflow a little bit so people have an idea of what they're looking at, you know, when I'm kind of whipping around here. Oh, hey, Axel. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I had to turn my game down. I don't know. Actuap always complains that I pop. So I think it just, I think maybe my pop filter sucks. Let me turn my gain back up. Let's change filters here. Maybe that one's better. So yeah, anyway, I don't know if maybe it would be good to have like a, because I could probably talk about all this stuff for a full hour. So I don't know, it might be useful to have a stream that is, that goes over this and is indicated in the, you know, the YouTube video notes. Ah, okay. Great. Awesome. Yeah, have like two different pop filters for this, and I'm not sure which one do I use. And should I get my Stetson and put that in front too, you know? Yeah, okay. Good to know. Maybe my interface going over my powered USB. Interesting. Thank you for the feedback, my friend. Another IRL friend of mine, by the way, Lord XL. One of the most skilled admins I work with. Thank you, buddy. I'm glad to see you here. We need to go for a bike ride. Okay. So I guess let's just get to it, huh? So this is, again, this is the first thing I really wanted to cover, but as it always comes to be, there was, of course, an unexpected problem. I was trying to get ready for the stream this morning. I can now operate in my Emacs terminal, and I thought, you know, let's, yeah, okay, plug that in, tight. Maybe, I hope that, no, we gotta, hopefully, you know, this I think is the first episode where I didn't come in sounding like Christian Bale Batman at first. It was bad. I kind of went on in advance and had Georgie check it out. So, anyway, I digress. So we're here in my Emacs terminal, and as you can see, this happened, and this is like, it's black blowing up again, and, you know, the thing that's supposed to help me is annoying me, so let's just go back to, I suppose we'll go back to just echoing this for now. I won't ever commit that. And the goal is to just run it in Docker, which I still actually have to do Docker in my separate terminal right here, because my Emacs terminal doesn't have the, you know, the group membership to do sudo or Docker or anything like that. It's just running Emacs in a daemon, and so it just does Emacs. That's it. Anyhow, so yeah, let's do this again. We get going. I thought I would leave that as a topic of conversation. And let's go here to Groundcover file. And so kelp. Yep, there we go. Okay. All right. So my first question is, what's it look like on the website? Kelp. Okay, yeah, wow, it's a part of quite a few things. Because I just loved the idea. Again, you know, little performance hack. Theoretically simple to install. So really, I think the only thing to do here is to remove the notes of mod lists and put a note about it's not compatible with Beautiful Cities of Morrowind. Just as like, you know, for posterity. So, okay. Usage notes. Where are we at here? Go bye-bye. subscriber. And this doesn't exist anymore. Good. And we'll delete that. Okay. Cool. Tests ran over here. That's fantastic. Let's run the server. Nice thing about my over here terminal is now I can just kind of have it there and not context shift as much. While this is chugging, we're going to pull up the data for each mod list. Just yank it out of there. Maybe someday we can revisit the concept. I don't know. Great idea. One day. I was clever and used the number one. I think you passed me. Goodbye. All right. And just like that. I doubt, though, that those were all caught in my little chuggage over there. So let's just go ahead and... This one has a lot of the ones I need, so I'm just going to copy it. Whoop. Oh my. Don't try this at home, kids. Need a little mouse action here. Okay. Get this. I'm going to put a changelog note in here. Don't actually really need to say, just we're removing it. That's really all that matters. We don't really need to say anything else. And you come. Oh my. That icon is huge. Great job. Okay. That is up. But let's go ahead and see what it looks like. Okay, kelp. Okay. We'll crunch the database one more time and then it'll be gone. No specific. Okay. That's something we forgot. Go ahead back here, back to the data files. So there's a plugin. So what's it called there? HM. Yeah. Okay. That can just all go away. Nice and clean. All right. That should be better. What else? Okay, all right, well, I think it's time to crunch again. And then let's pull up our handy-dandy list once more. And so, yeah, okay. Gonna say yes there, just for posterity. And I didn't actually do that. My fuzzy matching fail, there we go. Let's see. Yeah, I think just right here. Please note that this is not present. I was thinking about saying may not, but definitely is, and I would rather err on the side of caution, even if it updates in the future. Somebody will tell me. Making a link to beautiful cities of Morrowind. Actually, don't really yet have a great way to spawn the canonical link for things in here, but normally with Django you do something like a template. And it looks nice and neat, and you don't have a, like a hard-coded variable, or a URL rather, but it's what I got. All right. That should look good. I'm going to crunch it again, much as it pains me to do so. Check that off. Let's see more of this list here. Okay, this should be an easy one. Just delete stuff. I like that. Well, it would be delete it and then make it an alternative to Sculptus Combat. They kind of, you know, there is this one area, the bow zoom. So for, if you don't know, Marksman's Eye is made by moi. And it's code taken from Peter McKeeve's OpenMW Lua demos. And it basically controls the field of view to provide like a zoom effect when you draw your bow. And I put like a quest around it. You had to find like an item and be holding that item for the power to work and that kind of a thing. Sculptus doesn't quite work the same way, but it does have like a fatigue cost. And I feel like it's definitely balanced. And just, you know, you already got, hopefully you've already got Sculptus combat pack. And so, yeah, just use that. All right, boom. I feel like for posterity, I should say it's not active. Because it really isn't at the moment. And I'll change it if I hear out of Hemeris. You know, we'll roll with it again. All right. Yeah, I think this looks good. Let's go look at our change log. Added? No. No good. That was a boo-boo on my part there. And the date obviously is wrong. Today is what, 13? Saturday the 13th. And is that actually the... Yes, is that actually the... Let's see here. One day. Expanded vanilla. Graphics. Heart. Okay, yeah. Oh, wait. Yeah, that's everything. Outstanding. Crunch it again, and if it's all good, we'll commit. And this, you know, this is one that I think needs to go live today. I'm gonna, you know, commit this directly to the master branch, and that's getting committed. Ho! What did I do? Oh, okay. I made a boo-boo. Oh, huh. Okay, there you go. You might notice here that this guy is, right? We got our open one here and a closed one there, and I made a boo-boo. All right, well, let's just go back over here and try that again. Thank you, tests. Save me from my typo-making self. Ooh, pardon. Okay, back to the grand plan. Yeah, okay. That's done. Hopefully there'll be a few tickets, I think, issues in GitLab. I'll need to go through and close, but I won't. Honestly, I'm not a big fan of doing that kind of stuff, so we won't do that today. Or maybe we will if I finish absolutely everything else, but I doubt. Okay, so let's get a jump on the next change here. I just won't save. Marksman. That right there. This, I believe, is the gameplay. Wait. We're done over here. Removed. Excellent. Removed. And this looks pretty accurate. Not presently compatible. And the link is good. All right. This is a... By the way, this is something we're going to be tackling eventually. Okay, all right, that's done. So let's go ahead and commit that. Nope. Yep. All of this. Alright, remove. What is my mod name here? Exactly as I have it. Sign it. Oop. I was pretty amazed I didn't type anything thus far. Alright. And this is going to go into my existing merge request. I'm going to open for changes. Let's actually go get that. Oh my god, GitLab. Here you go. 5.3, part 3, the beginning. I felt a concise name was needed. Draft state, okay. Just now, boom. It's on there. Alright. CI pipeline is running. I'll just pull this up. Oh, wait. No, I have a better idea. Yeah. Lab CI. Oh. That's a bummer. My token expired. Put a very short life on it, and it expired. Okay, we'll do that another time. I'm not making a token right now. Wanted to just skip the browser. Look at this in the terminal like a cool kid. All right. So everything's going into here, and let's move on. Okay. So, gameplay. Marksman. Alright, so where the question is then? Camera. Of course. Picking categories is so hard. Oh my gosh. A little embarrassed there. Okay. And so I wanted to pull this up so I could just put a note about how it's an alternative to solas. So that way, at least, it's not like buried into the void forever. Excuse me. Excuse me. Oh my goodness. All right, and with that, goodbye. It was fun to make. I made it for last year. A lot of fun. Definitely fun to make it and learn about quest making and journal stages and stuff. Maybe in the future I'll make something, you know, more fun. Really wanted to make something for this year's marathon. I just don't see it really happening in time. You know, to make something like reasonably good takes a little bit of time. Don't even remember. Okay, well, one day modernization. Okay. Get there. Alrighty then. And then now we just do a quick changelog entry. I also really wanted to write a Lua mod with Lisp. You know, like use one programming language to make another language, because one language isn't quite enough. Jeez, don't try to sit on kids. There we go. Alright. No you. Right? Alright. Yeah, alright. Camera. I don't know. Like, in hindsight, why didn't I make that? I mean, I guess it is camera. It does zoom. Alright, I don't hate myself too much. Okay. Remove Marksman's eye from mod list. Okay. Gonna queue up a bunch of changes before I push. I don't know. I just feel bad spamming GitLab. Yeah, let's go back to the master plan. Alright. All right, so, oh boy. This definitely is an important chunk, but I'm going to jump ahead. Scumpatibility. All right. And what we're going to do is try to actually run OpenMW. And, you know, hope my computer doesn't melt too much. Oh, I'm not going to have sound. That's right. Not important. Boop! Oh. Well, I guess it is important for this purpose. Let's go ahead and... let's just go ahead and remove that. Boom. Okay. Let's try that again. What I'm trying to do here is demonstrate the problem. In a nutshell, you get close to some... we're using mods for really nice looking swamp textures. You get close to it and it like awkwardly disappears. Oh my. That's... my speaker, which I forgot to disconnect. Okay. I mean, I can honestly disable shaders. Maybe not. Good enough to show. So we got some really, you know, you can see here, looks pretty good. But then, yeah, right there you can just see it. We're not even really all that close. This is something relating to graphics and texture that is a little bit above my pay grade on the topic. But apparently we can just remove this compatibility textures and fix the whole thing. So let's just try that. Scum. Yeah. Just X that out there. Whoop. What did I do? Don't try this at home. Holy smokes. Hey, welcome, Michael. Sorry if I said that wrong. Thanks so much for joining. All right, I'm just looking at some awkward texture issues. All right. Hey, look at that. Yeah, looks a lot better. So I think the thing to do is to just simply not use that patch. Let's go ahead and scumpatibility. Let's see. Scumpatibility. Flora and landscape. Okay. Great. I happen to know this file lives, if I can type it right, next to the ground cover file. Zoom in a tiny bit here. Okay. Not really a huge edit that needs to happen here, but let's go ahead and good old MD. Mad respect. I don't know what time it is right now. Let's see. There we go. 11:30. And we just simply delete it. And it seems like mistify. Correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, that's the only note in there, so we can just erase it. Okay. Great. Oops. I was thinking for some reason this was a desperate mod, but it's not. So we got the usual suspects here. Just gonna go ahead and try to avoid typing as much as I can. I have not. Ooh, all right. Where were we here? Total overhaul. Graphics overhaul. Not on here. It's been one day. Okay. That. Covers that. But now we need a little bit. Now we need to do some of the text magic. Format string. F strings. I actually really love them. Okay. Mistify was updated. To remove instructions on using compatibility. That really should be it. This is a small, easy, good one. Nothing's really removed. And yeah. All right. Trying to mess with my compositor here. There we go. Sorry about the flashing. Okay, this is a. Let's commit it. Real quick, let's see. I should be doing due diligence here. There has to be some issue here. Yeah. I should have. So what I like to do is you can, it's a nice thing in GitLab. If I put in my commit message, you know, for example, #191, you put a note in the issue. GitLab reads the commit and puts me a nice note in the issue so I can have like a visual relation, you know, but it's too late for that. And just take a quick look if I have some scumpatibility issue here. Or dare I try? Just search for that. Oh my gosh. Okay, I regret doing that. All right. Remove mention of scumpat. And shout out to Poodle Sandwich and Remiros and Melchior Dark and everybody else who makes all these fantastic scummy mods that I just love. My laptop display is geeking out. It's irritating me. All right. Sorry about that. Sign it. Now, back to the grand plan. Check it off. All right. Let's see. All right. Where are we at? This one, I think we got to go through here. And it would be pretty easy. So let's pull up the data we got here. Landmasses, and let's pull up the website. Tamrial, just Tamrial, actually. Tamrial data. Okay. And Gonzo mentioned, you know, you really should say to use all the BSAs explicitly, and you really should. People are new to this, wouldn't just know. And I'm sure their instructions say it. Let's add to that knowledge. A little bit of raw HTML in a string. Nobody hated that too much, right? Okay. All three. Three. All right, bold text. Everybody likes that. Makes the intent a little more clear. Okay. I think it's been a minute. We should crunch the site. Crunch my local build of the site, that is. We're not quite done yet. I'm going to actually bump the updated date, put a change log, just to kind of call out attention to that. Oh, this is good. You see here, my friends, is my automated tests that I use to ensure the integrity of all the data that I'm putting into the website. And it kind of using the alternative to kind of depends on the order, unfortunately, things are created. So all we got to do to fix this, good thing I didn't push that, it totally would have failed. And we simply take that off of here. Let me see. Thankfully, I know my own Rube Goldberg machine pretty well. No need to worry. And let's fix that. Try it again. All right. Okey-doke. What was I looking at before I got distracted by annoying problems that I didn't want to deal with? All right. Oh. Focus fail. All right. So I think this is good. The CFG generator is going to say all the PSAs you need, so I don't really think I need like an extra note there. If somebody disagrees, I would love to hear about it. Let's get ready to pull that up. Mm-hmm. And back to the grand plan real quick while we wait for things to crunch. I assume they still are. Looks like they are. All right, yeah. This is a nice, easy one. We'll put a changelog entry. This is a big one, and I think in the second hour, I will address this one. Space Farmer, another IRL friend of mine. Thank you. No turtle. We didn't capture it. I can't promise there will never be cats. We don't have a cat in the house now, but maybe someday. Some personal notes. Ah, yeah, Michael. Question, what's on the left side of the screen? Thank you. That's a really great question. Those are my notes for the stream. Just to kind of try to attempt to stay focused. Attempt to stay focused on the stream as we were getting distracted by cats. What are you doing, man? Let me share this link in the chat, though, with you. And I got these up on GitLab, and I try my best to, keep them updated as I come up with things across the week in between. So I'm making a commitment to try and do these streams Saturday and Sunday each week. And just to keep the sort of the march of working on the website going, and but also to, like, space it out for myself so I don't go crazy, doing it. I love doing it, but... Yeah, so I edit it here locally, and I'll push, every now and then, maybe at the end of the day if I add a lot of things. But that's where it's going to live, and I guess, each year or whatever, we'll see how long this goes. We'll update there. So, yeah, that's the rough to-do list for the show. Ideas are welcome, comments, all that kind of a thing. I think you joined after I mentioned some of the things that are ticked off at the top. But, yeah, go check out the Dagothwave Bandcamp. They deserve props. Okay, now enough being distracted for now. Let's look at what we got here. And I wanted to see, Data.
Okay.
Bold text. All three BSA files must be activated. You know, I mean, I don't think I can say it much more clearly than that. So, I'm saying ship it on that. But, again, we want to, just for posterity, let's put a note on here. Okay. Very good. To remove instructions, include instructions now. To use all three BSA files. It won't be bold here. I'll take that chance. It could be. We're doing it. Let's crunch the site again. Oh no, what did I do? There we go. I'm kind of new to eShell, honestly. I've been using Emacs for like 9 years. Never mess with eShell too much. That's what you see on the right side. That's my Emacs-based terminal. Not really like a normal terminal. It just looks kind of like it. I digress. Okay. So... Vim, I use Vim too, don't worry. I love all things. I just had an experience with Emacs that kind of pushed me. Yeah, anyway, maybe we talk about that in the what you use. All things text-based, yeah. Or, you know, like, if I'm, like, editing text and suddenly I, like, want to really play Tetris, I'll just go ahead and... Let's go ahead and do that. I'm a really bad Tetris player too, by the way. Smalio, though, she is my... Okay, that's enough of that. Whoa, we got off the deep end there. How do I get anything? Well, we're asking the philosophical questions now, and I feel like I don't have a good answer to that. Especially when you're dealing with OpenFW, right? Like... Dealing with OpenFW, or just gaming and modding in general, it's so easy to get off the deep end. Let's just update this one thing, and then, you know, next thing you're on Nexus, looking at what was added in the last month, which is shockingly huge. I don't even need to check to know that for a 21-year-old game. Did I break the chat? Hold on. No, okay. Man, I don't know what I'm doing sometimes. Okay. Here's our website. Okay, nothing changed on this page. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, you know what? And I just thought, too, we need to bump the updated date on the mod itself. Mistify, updated. We didn't check that before. Tamrial dated, updated. Use all three BSA files. Okay. Let's see if these links work. In case I typo myself. Which is one of my secret abilities, is making typos. Let's give it a bump here. 23.05.13. All right, and I think with that, we can, I never did save this, very good, Steam Deck compatibility stream. Yeah, that's a great idea. I need to get perhaps a tripod for my GoPro. And so, because I feel like the best experience would be to see my grubby hands holding the thing. And like, you know, this is OpenMW on Steam Deck, or maybe we can like do something crazy and load up New Vegas or something entirely not remotely related to Morrowind at all. Oh my goodness. Getting crazy now. I do the big eyes during work meetings sometimes, and I love like watching people start laughing. Yes. I love watching people start laughing that are on camera. I'd be like, it's another one of my secret abilities. All right, what did we just do? We just did that. All right, Gonzo, thank you for that suggestion. It was good, very good idea. Very, very, very good idea. I don't know if there was a ticket. I don't know if I ever filed a ticket for that. Let's see. I did. I sure did. I made this the other day. Hey. All right. Cool. So we're going to give this a try. I can't make it bold here, but I would if I could. Wait. It's as close as we're going to get. I bet you some markdown renderer somewhere might actually make that bold. I bet you. Yeah, so GitLab sauce. Here we go. Actually, let's do one more thing. Part of 29. Okay. I put that up there. Let's see if the CI blows up. Here we go. And yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Got a nice little mention there. And if we look at the commit, we got a link back to the issue and the merge request and all that fun stuff. And look at the colors. Neato. I feel satisfied. Well, when this turns green, I'll feel most satisfied. All right, yippee. Checking things off the log. We're 25% done already? Whoa! Not even done with the first hour. That's pretty good. Okay. It helps to focus on easy stuff first. And this one, honestly, is easy and, you know, let's take a look at this guide that I was frankly really impressed with, but was busy to really give it a close look. So open Morrowind. Oh, Arfuzzo, we need to talk. It is not open Morrowind. Morrowind is a copyright of Microsoft or Bethesda or somebody. I don't know. Maybe I can open up. Yeah, open up pull request. All right, we're not going to do that today. I'm not even logged in. Oh, cool. All right. Yeah. Okay. This is a mod list. I definitely knew about the mod list. I'm pretty sure it's heavily using script extender mods, though. Oh, really, really neat. Okay. And actually, by the way, go to my handy-dandy resources page. Morrowind Sharp, which I guess is Morrowind +++++, right, if we're stealing from Microsoft naming of C Sharp. But not quite the same thing. I don't think it's on here. Let's see, +++. Nope. Okay, well, I mean, definitely deserves to be on there, you know. I don't use script extender mods. I've been told that they can work with Wine. I'm a Linux user, so I require to use Wine for Windows things. It's a system that lets Windows stuff run on not Windows, if you weren't aware. And I've been told the script extender and graphics extender work with Wine, but I just haven't tried it in a while, and it definitely failed miserably when I tried before. To borrow from a less than Jake song name, you know, some of my good friends use MWSE, and I love them. And their mods are definitely, an inspiration for some cool stuff that we can do in the future. I ported Abbott's smart ammo mod. 90% of the functionality to OpenMW Lua. So it's a good experiment source and a source of ideas. Moving on, though. Let's actually get this onto the website. How do we do that? So this page actually is one of the weird pages on the website that doesn't have any data on the database. It's just a flat HTML file. Template resources. There we go. And just to, you know, there's quite a few good stuff on here. Quite a few good links on here. Danae's good modding practice guide, you know, and I do note things not made for OpenMW, but a lot of them can be helpful to the budding OpenMW user or even the vet who, you know, they think they've been around the block a little bit. All right, so we're going to just call this Morrowind +++ probably. And I think the key thing, though, that people were in Discord when this came up in conversation was this section on tools. And this is useful in particular for Windows users because it goes over some neat stuff like mod organizer to OpenMW, mlocks, rymash, which is arguably the best polymus fork rymash, arguably the best graphical mod manager for OpenMW right now. I don't know if it works on Linux. I worked on porting it a few years ago and gave up. It would be, relatively speaking, an easy port because most of the problems I saw were like, you know, shelling out to Windows executables and stuff like that that would have to be de-hardcoded. You use like this Python zip library instead of shelling out to zip.exe or whatever. Anywho. All right. Go ahead and... I'm losing myself here. Resources. There we go. Yeah, you know, I'm going to put that right above Danae's. And I'm basically going to say, you know, Morrowind +++, it's a great mod list, not for OpenMW, and also an excellent resource. Oh, I feel like I should really mention this elsewhere, and we're going to do that. But it has to go here, too. Ooh, woo, 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 woo. Don't try this at home, kids. Okay, good. That's good. But we need more. And I'm thinking specifically let's not talk about the disorganization of the buttons right now, but that is a topic I hope to address in the future. I feel like it should go here. And specifically this tools page, but also, oh my. We've got a page somewhere. My blind TS3, where? I don't even know my own website. Did I take the page down? I'm a little confused right now. I guess it should just go here. Oh. Yeah, tips. Cleaning with, okay. I knew I had it somewhere. Let's see. Cleaning plugins. You cannot find that which does not exist. Yeah, it should definitely go here. Cleaning. All right. What do you know? It's even in the same directory. Just go in this list, really. At the top, honestly. And tools setup. Setup, tools, tool setup. It flows. All right. Cool. Tool setup, definitely don't need to link people to. That does not have anything to do with OpenMW. Tools could absolutely be useful. It's going in. Actually, there we go. Arguably should go directly to the that. There we go. All right. All right. So, checking that off. Over a quarter done in 99 hours. Feels good, man. Okay. Mention Morrowind. I also swear. Very good. Well, no, because the change log, that's a good, great question. Michael says, did you add a change log entry? And the changelog usually covers changes to the mod lists. This being, so that sort of points out, you know, an interesting problem. We have this changelog for demonstrating to the user what changes happen to the mod lists and when. I don't really have a good way of, you know, saying, oh, yeah, we updated the cleaning plugins page. Not on that version though, which reminds me, let's chug, shall we? Chug while I'm talking. I don't really have a good way to kind of show this. Yeah, so hey, you know, if you feel like hacking on a little Python, you know, let's talk on Discord sometime about it. I'm open to ideas. Like maybe we can have so the source of truth right now for that is the git log. And you could, you know, technically go to, I'm not even going to bother, you could go to GitLab and watch the activity and your eyes will bleed because the GitLab UI is painful. But maybe, you know, maybe there's a better way, or maybe it's like a manual change log. We can't automate it, you know, and we just kind of say it, you know. I'm open to ideas. Yeah. I'm open to ideas. Maybe it makes sense in the future to have like a general static pages change log. So people can follow that without having to look at, you know, a nasty git change log. You know, I like diffs personally, but I'm also not sane. Okay. Ooh. next up, gonna do this one. So this was a good... I don't use Mod Organizer 2. I don't personally have anything against Nexus mods. I am a premium subscriber and I love them and rely on them for content for many of my games, not just Morrowind. But, you know, I just like to know about and use other sources. Modding Hall, the creator of Modding Hall Sticks is a nice dude. We talked a lot and, you know, just like having alternatives and certainly having something on GitHub at least used to be kind of convenient because, you know, you could grab a zip file kind of for free and not have to bother with signing up or being rate limited or whatever. Maybe those days are coming to an end as Microsoft sort of asserts control. What did we just do? Morrowind plus plus. Let's look at it. Very good. Very good. And just for posterity, let's open that link. Cool. All right. Mad props to our Fuzzo on your sweet list and guide. So it's awesome. Giving you props as you deserve. Okay, yeah, so moving on. Tomb of the Snow Prince. What is Tomb of the Snow Prince? It's a landmass mod that basically takes the Blood Moon landmass, Solstheim, and makes it, you know, a little bit more of an artistic design. Because I don't want to say the vanilla design is bad, you know, it's just from, it's from the years of EverQuest design. And it kind of shows. Tomb of Snow Prince. Yeah, I'm pointing to GitHub here. Probably suboptimal. When I step aside from the things that I personally like and put myself in the shoes of somebody who's trying to play Morrowind, probably not the best page to put them to, because there's the same gripe I have with GitLab, frankly. How do you know what to download? You know, do I even say really what to download here? Yeah, I guess I do, kind of. Anyway, you know, it shouldn't be that. We shouldn't put people there, you know. So let's go ahead and Tomb of the Snow Prince. I'm searching off camera, apologies. Nexus mods. And I happen to know that's in the data as a landmass. Anthology, Tomb of the Snow Prince, Soul Sign. Wow, there's a few different. Okay, that's a Skyrim mod. Here we go. This is what we want. This is the one. Okay. Go ahead and, yeah, definitely. And yeah, just taking a quick look at this. I mean, that's real nice. You know, not just like the flat kind of, if you've never seen Blood Moon, it's just kind of like flat terrain, you know, and EverQuest kind of trees. Maybe a little bit fancier than EverQuest, not much. And this is just a lot more of an inspired landscape, you know. Hills and things. If you crazy you ever played Skyrim and you saw Dragonborn content, you've seen a vision of this area here that is not too much unlike this, you know. And yeah, it looks fantastic. These I think are all done with vanilla and not OpenMW. You can kind of tell the fog has like a bluish hue to it. All right. Let's download it too. Okay, yeah. I have come here at some point. Past me. Download. All right. And we got this file here. And yeah, it's packaged in the, you may be familiar with, format folder with the name of a digit, space, a category. Not sure of the name of that pattern, but it's, you know, used by big projects. And it's something mod managers look for. Whereas the one on GitHub is just like random folders. I don't know. Maybe they have some CI process that packages it this way. I don't know. But anywho, so that means we got to change what we've got in here. Tomb of the... Yes. Huh, all right. Maybe not too much. Core. Tomb of the snow prince. Edges. No, yeah, it's all there. Oh, good. Hey, it's always fun how that works out. Oop. My face is in the way. Alright. Well, that's always good. Seems like we just need to change the link, really, and then maybe the usage notes would say things about the link we just changed. Oh, dear me. There we go. Oh, don't try this at home, kids. There we go. All right. So what is actually on there? How badly are we derailing people here? Okay, yeah. No, that's going away. That means nothing in the context of the new download link. That file name has got to change. Download the... unhelpful link. Be gone. OpenMW 0.48 should only load ground cover from ground cover files. I'm not sure. And ooh, wow, that is an old one. That lingered for a while. This should have been deleted a long time ago. Oof, big oof. Graphics overall, people want Solstheim graphics replacer. Oh, come on. Contents of the... Cool, hey, that's like deleting more stuff than adding. I always love that. Let's crunch it. There will be a change log. And pardon me while I drink some fruit. All right. And how widely used is this one? Okay, yeah, the big three. So, yet another updated. Get rid of you, knock you out. We don't need both for this one. Direct users to Nexus mods for the downloads. All right. Very good. Cool. Change logs. Didn't crunch yet, so this might actually be in our build. Good point, Michael. We are... I'm going to sleep on that because I don't really know. I'm struggling with how to word it. And I want to see it on the page first. Finished. Yeah, it might be too long too. I'm trying to keep it concise. It is worth saying that information, but maybe it's also implied. Oh. I guess it didn't get... We have to crunch again. Okay. Before we do that... Yeah. Looks good to me, I think. Yeah, I think that's good. All right, I think this was the only one I'm going to look at today. But this is potentially a problem with other things. I've in the past kind of preferred to, you know, do it on Nexus Link, but really that's not what most people want. That's just what I want. Excuse me. And I am not most people. And anyway, the Nexus in this case is clearly, you know, it's just the better option. You're using Nexus, you're used to, I would argue their user interface is not that much more intuitive than GitHub, but certainly, you know, you're used to using it more. You know, if you've never looked at GitHub, it's just like, okay, what am I doing here? Oh yeah, committing, we're change, download links, 2 point. I don't think I have a GitLab issue for this. Not going to check. This is interesting. Language server issue. I'm just going to not care about it right now. Which is the right thing. It's one reason why I stopped liking Python too much. As I've said before. But it's one of those things... You know, I'm kind of stuck with it for this website until I quit my job and rewrite the whole thing in some other language that's better. Which is a good idea, right? No, it's not a good idea. Next month for downloads. Yeah, I guess. Nothing else really changed. Yeah, if not Python, what? That's a deep question, Michael says. I've mentioned this in one of the other streams that wasn't recorded. And really should, you know, I'll hold off on going into a lot of detail until I... Erlang. Yeah, Enterprise. No, nothing against Erlang whatsoever. It's probably awesome. Made by the Ericsson people. I believe. No, my plan for this website, though, I think in the future of this website is to be a statically generated website. Use a static website generator tool that can have a semi-complex build process that allows us to funnel data in some format, right? So like the data for mods, for example, maybe you noticed, ooh. Maybe you noticed if you've been following along that the data is in a Python dictionary format, which may make you cringe. And, you know, what can I say? It's a thing that I did without going into a lot of detail. I just didn't want to have database backups. So we would need some way to take this data that you see all the mods are in. This is kind of a no short entries. Here we go. You know, this is your mod data. It's a dictionary, just key value. So what's nice about it is, yeah, it's just key value. And it should be theoretically not too hard to put it into some format that could be consumed by a static website generator tool. And that would have a lot of benefits, but it would also create problems. For example, we have pages like the config generator, which rely on dipping into the database. To know things. So if I click this button, hits the database, and that's how it knows about all this stuff. It pulls this stuff from these various records. And so this is not unsolvable as a problem, but yeah, I mean, so now we have another sub project of rewriting stuff like this in JavaScript, basically. Or having like a, if we needed to stay a Python program, or maybe we wanted to make a, I like JavaScript, don't hate, vanilla JavaScript, to be clear, nothing against Node or anything or TypeScript, but I try to avoid, just stick with the vanilla for better or for worse. But like we could keep it as an external app still, you know, we could just like route the CFG generator endpoint. That's exactly what I do for the name generator, which is a completely different web app, a static website, actually, this thing right here, hosted on a different server. And yeah, just it's, you know, the machinery here is JavaScript, thoughtfully written JavaScript, you know, not like Twitch, for example, JavaScript, where the whole page will not function unless you have, you know, 100 megabytes of JavaScript. That's an exaggeration, but yeah. You know, this is thoughtful, small amounts of JavaScript, and we can do the same on the config generator. We can have a JavaScript application that's not horrible, in theory. I won't be doing that anytime soon, though. But if I were to quit my job and make working on the website my job and just do OpenMW stuff, that it would be something that I would try to plan for. If I had a large amount of time, convert it off of Python, out of this Rube Goldberg machine that I have, you know, created with a very delicate process here, off of all that, and it would just simply be static files and maybe easier for people to contribute, right? I have to think about like, oh, did I add a change log and is it the right category and did I add the right tag and is the this, that, and the other thing, you know, and there's a lot of things for my human brain, puny human brain, to keep track of, and I make mistakes. And, you know, so maybe more of that could be automated with a static website, or maybe more of it can be automated now and I just haven't done it right. I don't know. All right. So, what did I just do? Nexus by default, right? That's what I just did. And I committed it. Cool. Very cool. Oops. Don't try this at home. Kids. All right. What else do we got? Stream link on the website. I don't know. Where's it going to go? This one. Yeah. Okay. Footer. Oh, yeah. You know, I was reading about footer links the other day. And it's an interesting design concept. It could go in the footer. I mean, what do we have there now? We've got, you know, just some, like, arguably we could have a lot of other useful things there. That's a good idea, Michael. That is a very good idea. But I'm going to skip ahead to this one, which again was some feedback. If you were with us when I first got started, some feedback. Somebody had started using mod list, 419 mods. And, you know, on here, I give you a kind of a path down here where you can, you know, where you can put it. Some kind of an organization, right? Like you have a base folder, your category, your mod name, whatever. By no means do you have to use that. By no means is it the best way to organize. Maybe you're using mod manager software. Maybe you've got a secretary doing it for you. I don't know. But some people don't follow my naming, and that's respectable. However, when you get here to the end of the mod list, there's the final checklist step, and they direct it is directs users to this page, which has, you know, all of the paths that I came up with, hard-coded. And so if you've been following along yourself at home and you made up your own paths, you might have done something that's not exactly this, and that's not this, oh, I can just find and replace username out there and put my name in there. You might be in a bit more of a sticky situation. So the concern was mentioned, you know, in the usage, basically. So I don't know. Right here. I'm not sure how many people end up looking at this to begin with, but maybe mention right here in this sub bullet. By the way, the folder paths it gives are hard coded. If you don't use them exactly, you may have a bad time or something. Let's see here. Where does this file even come from? Detail. There we go. Appropriately named mod list detail. And I think this is where it should go. So for the folks that do take a look here, they can get kind of a warning, you know. It's going to just have assumptions about those paths. In the future, this is another thing that I really wanted to allow for a minute now, which is maybe it would be a little more difficult to say, okay, excuse me, I am going to set a custom path for every mod, although that's doable, certainly. We could say my base path is bleh. And we could do that on this settings page. We could do it with JavaScript, vanilla JavaScript. Actually, that's how this works. We use the JavaScript storage API to just, you know, give you an opportunity to select your theme, and then we store it. And you know, the nice thing is that's actually kind of a good API, you know. To my understanding, other websites, it's sandboxed out from other websites. They can't see what's in there. Not that this website would have anything, you know, sensitive. But, yeah, so we could say configure, you know, maybe we could let the user click in there and set it per mod. That would be pretty easy to do, but more work than just saying the base is blah. And users could save that. And it would be a fun little bit of an OS. Yeah, right. You can, and they can set their OS if I don't correctly guess it. I think Google was trying to get rid of user agent, which is what I do now. I look at user agent string. Yeah, exactly. So people could set that on their own if they wanted to. Something I would like to do, but yeah, not really a high priority. I feel like this is a good thing for a new user to do, who wants to, like, write some JavaScript. I digress. Please note that the CFG generator will use hard-coded folder paths. So if you don't use what's on each mod detail page, what it gives you won't. 100% confident in that. I need to see it on the page. Excuse me. The CFG generator will use hard-coded folder paths. Oh, you know, I don't even need to crunch the website for this, because this is just a static page. Oh, enjoy your coffee. I had mine a few hours ago. I tried a coffee up before the stream. That way I don't look like too much of a fiend drinking obscene amounts on camera. Want to convey, though, yeah, just a CFG generator will use hard-coded folder paths. If you don't use what's on each mod detail page, what it gives you won't match. I think that's And I think it's probably okay.
I think the sun is coming out.
Cool. Still a bit of a cloudy, rainy day out here. All right. Checking it off. 35%. Feels good. Got about 30 minutes left. So I got to think carefully about what I want to look at. And I think I'm going to take this time. Let's look at something new. And by new, I mean this guy. So let's... get my folders here. Armor. What am I thinking? Audio. There we go. All right. M-A-O. Losing my voice. Spell sounds. 62 high bitrate .wav files. Sound effects for each of the schools of magic, as well as enchantments. Wow, cool. The specific sound effects sounds come from Morrowind Acoustic Overhaul by Peterbit. Peterbit is, if you don't know, basically a legend in the community, and he's made a lot of awesome stuff. They have made a lot of awesome stuff. It doesn't exist anywhere on the website presently, though, because, oops, don't try this at home. I don't believe that the Morrowind Acoustic Overhaul actually works for OpenMW. Maybe we can find it on here. Okay, yeah. Doesn't say that MWSE is a requirement. It says it removed the workaround. Hey, Gonzo. Thank you for dropping in. It's a pleasure to see you. We're just in the home stretch here. Fixed a bunch of stuff and now trying to look at something fun. I think I'm actually going to load up MAO spell sounds on my local setup and just, you know, let's experience it. Let me turn off my Bluetooth speaker, though. All right. All right, let's download this one. That's exciting. Sound replacer mods have existed, obviously, if, you know, since the olden days, but I was never really completely sold on Better Sounds, despite having used it for many years, and actually very recently, I just decided to stop using it altogether. My wife really likes the vanilla potion sound. It's like a bubbly kind of sound. And so when I was testing out some OpenMW Lua stuff, I decided, let's go vanilla sounds. And it was really fun to hear the bubble potion sound again, you know. And I thought, no, the vanilla sounds are not that bad. Come on. Although, yeah, some of the magic sounds are a little dated, to put it nice, maybe. So, okay. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. And just for posterity here, you know, simple mod, it's only sound files. All right. Let's add it in here. No plugin, gotta love it. Oh, yeah. Also. I forgot to look. Our little note here. Yeah, I think that's fair. It conveys somewhat succinctly what I want to say, and hopefully it gives people the message. You can't use your own folder pass with a CFG generator yet, but I would really like to allow that. All right, well, let's run the game. But not total overhaul. Minimal. Yeah, all right. Okay. Let's do something here real quick. No reason I should be getting potato performance on that. Should be off. Am I even doing this right? Trying to disable object paging, and I forget what the config is for. I just don't want distant anything. I just want to run the game and hear some sounds. It is off. Active grid object paging is on, though. I bet there's something funky there. And I see my desktop is geeking out again. That's cool. No, no, no. I don't want any of that. Okay. So y'all can hear the... Whoop. So you folks can hear the sound too, hopefully. This is awkward. I have an idea. All right. Nope. No dice. Let's try it again. Might be too loud. Brace yourself. Yeah, I can hear it now. Good, good. Just need to see it. All right. It is a bit of a cool sound for like a casting a shield. Oh. mean, okay, that's pretty cool. Rather like this. You know, it's subtle. And that's the thing I think I didn't really love about better sounds. It was a bit heavy. Alright, like it insane. Okay. Does this space farmer, great question, does this have a battle royale mode or mod? Well, so, out of the box, OpenMW doesn't support multiplayer. However, there is a fork that has multiplayer capabilities. It's called TES3MP, and the plan is to converge the code bases at some point. OpenMW will have multiplayer. The Lua modding API is being designed with multiplayer in mind. Somebody was working on a battle royale script for TES3MP at one point. Testman was. I don't know if they ever finished it. But he even had the like shrinking the map concept and yeah, it should though. The thing about Morrowind in PvP is it's utterly broken, you know. And so a lot of work would need to go into like making PvP actually fun. You know, because right now it's just like there are very clear things that are very clearly better than other things, and if you just try and play to have fun, you're probably not gonna have like you're not gonna have like the most powerful character out there. Okay, so we looked at this. I like it. I really wanna play more with it. It seems like a strong contender. You know, I want to hear all the spells and giving it a quick look. I mean, I can say already, super easy to install, no plugins, strictly an asset replacer. Doesn't get much better than that. And the sound was great. Subtle, not heavy-handed. Not trying too hard to, like, zow ya, you know. I like it. Very good. Thank you again, Magamo, on that suggestion. So, here we are. Whoop. Let's see where we're at with git commits real quick. Mod list detail. Mention folder paths are hard coded in. All right. Sign it. Push it. And let's run tests really quick, just as a sanity check. Oh my, what? Oh, here we go. Let's run tests as a sanity check, and then do a website deploy, because the next thing I would like to work on is going to take a minute, and I am not going to finish it today, and that would be looking at Remiros mods that exist in the graveyard page. Some background. The modder, it is not uncommon for modders to have mod pages on Nexus mods where it's one mod page with many mods listed individually. Remiros has decided that they want to, you know, sort of collect their old stuff, put them in the graveyard. So now all my other links are broken right now. And so at this point, got about a little under 20 minutes left. I want to look at what's the damage look like, what mods are kind of broken right now, and then tomorrow we can dig into like really. This is a little bit different than your normal update because we've got links now that are going to be broken, and we need to make sure that we preserve them and avoid link rot. So let's just look at one. I can guess here. Remiros Alcohol HD, I assure you, is one of them. And you can see right here, the mod has been hidden. Links, yeah, link rot is it's a thing that can be avoided on my part. And so what we're going to want to do then is we're going to take this slug here, because we are going to, that's a good idea. So I actually thought about that, following our various discussions off stream farmer about ChatGPT, I thought, you know, this website updating task is so mundane, but like would be probably good for large language model like ChatGPT, right? Just be like, okay, scan my code, now update that mod, and then like it would be done in like a minute. Whew. We gotta play with that. Future stream, let's do that actually. It's going on the list. Extra exclamation points, question marks, and actually, look, check it. This is how serious we are. It's a great idea, especially for like documentation type things, you know, and what it doesn't get right, you know, completely right. I can look at the diff at least and sort of sanity check it. Oh, great idea, farmer. You the man. All right. I definitely was thinking about it. You read my mind, but since you brought it up, it's going on the list. Because a big problem that I have is the maintenance of the website is, you're the idea man, Space Farmer says. I am full of them when I said great idea. You're the idea man, buddy. One of the issues I've had maintaining the website over the years is that it just, yeah, shit ideas. I'm full of them too, don't worry. And full of shit in general. We all are. Low, low, low. Seriously, on a serious note, though, one of the problems I've had with maintaining the website over the years is as it grows, yeah, tests work. As the website grows, and features are added, the amount of work that it takes to make just one change is, you know, it's a lot. And it's a lot to think about. And in order to keep things happening at a consistent pace, so that changes can happen expediently, you know, we need a way to streamline it, you know, and ChatGPT or some usage of a large language model outputs, you know, could potentially really help. Not tomorrow. Farmer says, how many people are working on it consistently beside yourself? Nobody. Really, I mean, I get a lot. So the conundrum I have is I have an incredibly huge amount of input from lots of great people in a community that's entirely active, and really dedicated to the game and OpenMW and stuff. And I'm fortunate for that. But my website is such a pile of shit Rube Goldberg machine, that even somebody who knows Python, even somebody who knows Django, especially if you know Django, you would look at what I've done and just be like, oh my, you know, this is unorthodox, to say the least. There's just so much that has to happen. You know, I've effectively abused a model view controller with a relational database application as a static website. You know, I am bearing the lead on this is the architecture of the website. It's you can kind of see it happening here. You know, we're drop the database every time I deploy the website. Unorthodox, to say the least. Yes. We drop the database. And then we seed all the data back in from those Python files that I was looking at. And again, bearing the lead on this is the website infrastructure discussion. Oh yeah, it works great. So that's the thing. Like I didn't want to. Farmer says, but it works, right? And Gonzo says, you know, unorthodox to say the least, no doubt. When I made the site, I did not expect, you know, let's just take a for posterity also. Oops, that's my own. My bad. That's my website. When I built this website, I was not saying we need to build a web application for 50,000 users a week. I never expected that many users. Not even a fraction. Yes, yes. So I thought, nobody's going to use this. I'm just making this so that I can, if it works, do not touch it. Yeah, well, yeah, I mean, so it's a double-edged sword. When I made the website, though, I didn't think people were going to use it. It was just for my personal benefit, you know, to learn Python a little more, to work with Django, to work with, you're looking at my Ansible stuff on the screen and everything, you know. I just like to get my hands on. And so I was just getting hands on, and I didn't think anyone's going to use it, let alone contribute. Why would anybody want to contribute? And so that's why I built it that way. I wanted something that would have low maintenance, that would have like a low to no burden of persistent data, you know, because persistent data is just like, wow, now I have to do a database backup every night. But I also get to, with non-persistent data, I can cheat and use caching everywhere, pretty much. Gonzo says, what parts do you think need the most work? Well, and that's part of the kicker, too. Most of the work that needs to be done is not extremely technical. It's mostly like just data entry. It's just wrangling with the kind of somewhat possibly horrible data system that I have, which is just this Python data here, you know? So it's basically making sure that the right content is here in the data, making sure that it's accurate and up to date. You know, what if modder A puts all their stuff into a graveyard, like what we're looking at right now, you know, and just the extreme amount of things that happen that are great problems to have. You know, your favorite game is 21 years old and modders are updating and creating new content so much, you know, that you have a constant stream of changes. But the fact is, that's the vast majority of changes that are needed are just like data entry and stuff. Of course, there are plenty of like back-end features that I need to flesh out, would like to flesh out, that involve like getting into the database or maybe doing some Python. But I mean, you don't need to be a Python expert really to, you know, to work with this. You just have to be, have, you know, a high tolerance for this. Which I guess I've become numb to over the years. But again, you know, it works. It definitely works. The website runs on a... So again, I'm going to point you back here to this traffic count. This is on a server that costs me less than $5 a month. It's one CPU core. It's 2 gigs of RAM, 10 gigs of storage, nothing. You know, it's like... So, I mean, I'm extremely happy, like, as a programmer, as a systems engineer, as a server aficionado, I'm very, very happy with the performance and visitor counts that I get pumped out of here, the performance on the web app. And actually, that reminds me, we need to load test the website sometime, and I can show you folks load test the website. I can show you the kind of throughput that we get on a, you know, cheapo one core virtual machine. But I'm not joking. Performance is just it's very good. Farmer asks, what host are you using? And let me pull it up. I'm using OVH, though. I'm not going to pull up their website. I don't get any money from them. I'm using OVH, though, and they have basically dirt cheap VMs that you can get unmanaged completely. So if you know what you're doing with servers, you know, you just get in there. And I mean, I've been using them for 10 years now. I started my sort of career in tech working at a web hosting company. Get the affiliate link. Whatever. I mean, I like them, but not that much. I started my career in tech working at a web host. So by the time I started using OVH, I had like 3 or 4 years under my belt, and I knew what I wanted, I knew what I liked, and I knew what I didn't like. And so, you know, the fact that I stuck with OVH for 10 years, I think at least says that they're good bang for your buck if you want just a no-frills Linux virtual machine. And yeah, so I mean, that's, these kinds of numbers are just beyond what I ever expected with the kind of accidental success we have at the website here. Look at this. Pale Moon. And just like these kinds of results here. Like I look at things like this and I'm just blown away. Like people from all over the world. I'm big in Algeria. So one feedback I've piece of feedback I've gotten from OVH though is that if you go, I used to self-host videos. So let's, for example, take a look at the video I have for the Total Overhaul tour. I used to self-host those because I was trying to avoid YouTube, like a crotchety old guy. See, my channel icon is there for a reason. I'm an old man shaking his old man cane in his rocking chair. But I used to self-host these videos, and this is like, I don't know, a 4-gig video at 1080p. And coming out of OVH, which is obviously just based in Montreal, Canada, you know, if you're somebody in, like, Lysol was telling me he's in Sweden, and he could barely load the video, and that's a big problem, you know? So, like, obviously, what I'm trying to say is don't expect geographic performance out of a small, cheapo server, but, you know, with that being said, I'm very happy with the performance I get here, and I think it lags a little bit now because my high-grade potato is chugging because of streaming. But, I mean, hey, I'm not complaining. Very cheap. And I'm happy with the sort of thing I invented. So, yeah. Geez, I lost track of what I was going for here. Load test the website will be in a future thing. Deploy the website. Tick that off. CI for the app image. Ooh, run MLocked. Ooh. I think we can do this one real quick as a last thing, and I'll deploy the website one more time. Okay, so right now, validator. This is a little thing I wrote in Go, and I wanted something that would, it's a command line program, and I wanted something that would, thank you, load super fast, love it, thank you, Space Farmer, yeah, you know, that's just what I wanted. Slow pay. I didn't want somebody with like a bandwidth limit to be like, oh, I have to load this page. It's going to like eat a third of my allowance. But anyway, back to the validator. I wanted something that would scan my CFG file and tell me if there were problems. Did I typo something? Does a folder not exist? Or does the plug, that just any number of things that could go wrong when you're doing things the OpenMW way without a graphical program like Mod Organizer or Rhyme Mash to do it for you, or you know, if you're a port mod user, would do it all for you. You wouldn't have to worry about it. But if you're like me and you don't mind just dropping some text in a text file here, you know, sometimes you may typo something, you may do something wrong, and so that's where the validator comes in as a helpful kind of thing. And I will go ahead and run it. I have a little shell script that I made to wrap it. But basically, yeah, it very quick too. I made a Python version. We can see here, OpenMW mod checker was a Python version that I wrote, and it would take minutes to run. And I think one of the issues was I just was a worse programmer then when I made that, but it just was terrible. And then now this one that I made with Go, probably a little bit of the speed can be chalked up to, you know, native machine code generated by the Go compiler versus Python being slow. But I think the mod checker was mostly slow because of my bad programming, and now I'm a little better and the validator is fast. And I direct people to Modding Hall. This is something I put on Modding Hall. 4,000 downloads. Pretty neat. As a side note, Farmer says he likes my prompt. And I just want to call out that this is... So my shell is a fish shell. And the prompt I got is from some theme collection I found online. It's called Batman, as I recall. And I just cargo culted it, put it into my .files repo, you know, 10 years ago and never touched it. Things that does that are nice is if I, like, you know, have an exit code that's non-zero, I get red arrows here, I get an exit here, get information, excuse me, in time. So yeah, thank you for noticing. It's kind of neat to write a command line thing on Linux, mostly for Linux people, but also make it available for Mac and Windows and see, you know, 4,000 people downloaded this. And I've seen people on Windows that are not normally execution time. That's a good point. You know, people that are not normally using command line things are using this. And so, I mean, it just feels kind of neat that that so many people get to use it. And so what it does is, I'm going to zoom out a little bit here so we can see it a little bit better. But, I mean, it's very verbose. It gives you a lot of information. It goes through your config file, looks at all your data paths. It finds the files in your data paths, with some exceptions of things that we know are not files we care about, like a .git folder. It's not going to have any mod files in it. Or whatever. You know, a .zip is not something we're loading in the engine. And then blah, blah, blah. It as it walks the tree of your data paths, it says, oh, okay, bam, you have this file. It replaced the other one that we found. So here we can see this mod here. Remiros alcohol again. Hey-ho. It's replacing not only a vanilla Morrowind file, but also some stuff from Better Meshes, which maybe we want to just go with that instead. When we fix this one, the link, we should actually, honest to goodness, check and see, you know. Does the Resdane Revival folks mesh look better? Maybe it does. I mean, honestly, off the top of my head, I can't think of it, but I'll tell you what, these ones do look pretty sweet. So props to Remiros. But yeah, so the validator is really, really quite boring, but it's also, you know, very useful. You know, I mean, this is part of my workflow here. When I'm working on mods and such, let's just open up that script here, validate.shell. Nothing magical here, just a little bit of helpful bash. And if I call just this script, it'll validate all my mod lists. So if I'm making changes, you know, because I keep local usable copies of all the mod lists so that I can run through them and see how things look. And when I'm making changes, you know, this is a really great sanity check, as you can see here. Like, oof, yeah, I was facing some Delta plugin problems with the latest version. We need to open a bug for Benjamin. He broke it. And you can see here, so yeah, this is like I have configured this plugin file, and it doesn't exist. It's not there. We got a problem. Some problems were detected. And so, yeah, I feel like this kind of output, you know, if you're using Mod Organizer 2, it gives you like a visual about all that. You don't really need this. I don't use Mod Organizer 2. I don't plan on it. If they had a Linux build that worked without a fuss, I would consider familiarizing myself with it a little more, but you know, I don't got time for that now. Wow, okay, well, hey, it is time. So didn't quite get this totally done right now. I have moved the source code into the GitLab organization that I have for the project, and just to kind of keep things group together, I think it would be really good to, you know, put people here instead of to my personal source hut. And source hut is probably not the best place to direct non-programmers to. If you're a programmer, you might think it's great. You might still also hate it. I'm a big fan. But I think this is a better home for it. And so one of the things we're also going to need here is we're going to need a CI job. And I would also like to give it sort of the same treatment I have for some of my Lua mods, where I'm publishing like a little website for it, you know, and keep publishing to Modding Hall. They have a developer's API that we can probably use to publish to via CI. Just be a little bit of, we'll have to dip our toes into secrets and stuff like that. Okay, well, I need to go eat lunch. It was a good session. We, 39%, 11 out of 28 things. I think I went in with like two things done though. Yeah, two things done. Good. Thank you for joining me, and thank you for watching if you're watching after the fact. And I shall see you in the next stream. Goodbye.